cacti make us think of southwestern deserts, certainly not Illinois. But there are three native prickly pear species that can be found in our state. This is Rhonda Ferree with the University of Illinois Extension. The first two prickly pears are found in isolated areas of Illinois. Little prickly pear is found mainly in Joe Davies County, and big-rooted prickly pear is found rarely in Illinois. The third type is found in about half of Illinois counties. It is called Eastern prickly pear, Devil's Tongue, or Hardy prickly pear. It is commonly found in sandy or hilly areas along the Mississippi and Illinois rivers. You see it here in Mason County. It is also found occasionally in the hills of southern Illinois and sandy sites of northern Illinois. The eastern prickly pear is a spreading, sprawling plant that forms clumps of 3 feet wide and 1 foot tall. The clumps are composed of flat green pads that are covered with clusters of short, reddish-brown, barbed bristles. From experience, I know that the bristles are small but painful when embedded in the skin. Occasionally, a 1 to 4 inch light gray spine also emerges from the pad's surface. Prickly pear have especially striking flowers. They are 2 to 3 inches wide, satiny yellow, sometimes with a reddish center. The blooms are found in early summer for about a month, although each flower only lasts a day. One or more flower buds can form on the top of a pad. Flowers turn into an edible berry fruit that is full of seeds. Prickly pears are great pollinator plants. The elegant flowers are mainly pollinated by bees, particularly our native bees. To ensure pollination, the flowers have a special technique that was first noted by Charles Darwin. These cacti have anthers that curl over and deposit their pollen when touched. Throughout history, prickly pears have been valuable plants in America. The edible pads and fruit are an excellent food source, making tasty jelly, candy, and drinks. I've had pickled cactus and found it was slimy but pretty good. In addition to food, the plant spines are used as needles for sewing, and a red dye can be made from an insect that thrives on the prickly pear. In fact, some sources say the bright red insect dye was used to make the red coats of the British Army.
You can find more information at our University of Illinois Extension website shown here. Or you can post questions and see other gardening tips at one of my IL River Hort social media sites serving Fulton, Mason, Peoria, and Tazewell counties.